I'd like to do something a little bit different with you, Russell. Hopefully you'll like it. We call it the IMD Bunker, where we go through IMDb's trivia page for you.
Oh, okay.
And a lot of it is rubbish. No offense, IMDb. But we just want to sort the wheat from the chaff.
Right.
Here's an example. Are you a Leeds United fan?
I am.
And what brought that about?
In the early 70s, my brother and I would watch Match of the Day in Australia. There was generally only, one game on a week. And it usually would take place just after we'd played our own sports. We'd play sports in the morning, so you're still kind of wound up. And Saturday was also the day that we'd get 50 cents each to go and spend on lollies, right? So we'd go and get massive amount of lollies and sit down in front of the TV. My brother and I, apart from the All Blacks, had never chosen the same team in any sport. We're very annoying siblings in that way. So we had a split household, whether it was rugby league, rugby union, football, doesn't matter. Australian rules, always on a different team. Even Sheffield Shield cricket, we had different teams. But yeah, so he chose Liverpool and I chose Leeds. I mean, this is back in the days of Billy Bremner and a very dominant side,
Yeah, and your brother must be very happy right now because they're top of the league.
Yeah, I'm trying to avoid his emails.
Apparently, you are going to donate your brain to medical science.
That started with an article on a former Prime Minister of Australia, Gough Whitlam. And but that was the article as it came out. Gough had been it had been requested of him, and so he said, "Okay, when they divide up my organs, you can have my brain." But of course, that wasn't good enough for the British press because they couldn't remember who Gough Whitlam was. So it became me.
So similar. When you were younger, Rusty was your nickname.
That's become more of my nickname now.
Ah, okay.
Nobody called me Rusty when I was younger. They used to call me Crazy. That was one of the nicknames that went on for quite a while, mainly because I was the sort of kid that I was up for anything if it was going to make you laugh, So that got me into a fair bit of trouble, but all in good natured fun. Yeah, Rusty is now the nickname that Australians have chosen to give me, and every man, woman, child, and dog feels it's okay to call me that to my face, which is it's not my favorite.
Speaking of nicknames, apparently your music career began under the name Russ LaRock.
It did, indeed, actually. I
People don't
did.
shout that at you.
What was that?
No one shouts that at you.
No. That was I started working in a nightclub that was it was an anachronistic sort of 1950s nightclub, and everybody had to have a nickname. So I was given that nickname. I was the DJ, but I also used to do a singing set towards the end of the night when most people were either drunk or had gone home. And that was the nickname that the guy that ran the nightclub gave me, and which I lived with for about 3 years and three or four records. But when I left New Zealand as a 21-year-old to, because by that stage I'd been touring and playing and doing the DJ work for 4 or 5 years. And in between times I'd done some acting stuff, most notably the 1986 New Zealand tour of the Rocky Horror Show. And I just knew that as much as I loved music, it was the acting that was sustaining the music. So I left New Zealand and left that name behind.
And became Rusty.
Rusty Crowe.